Thus I have heard. At one time, the Buddha was in Shravasti residing in the Jetagrou in Anathapindika's park. Along with a great assembly of bhikshus, 1250 in all. At mealtime, the Bhagavan put on his robe, picked up his bowl, and made his way to the great city of Shravasti to beg for food within the city walls. After he had finished begging sequentially from door to door, he returned to eat his meal. Then he put away his robe and bowl, washed his feet, arranged his seat, and sat down. From the midst of the great assembly, Elder Sabhuti then arose from his seat, bared his right shoulder, knelt with his right knee on the ground, with his hands joined together in respect, he addressed the Buddha saying, "How extraordinary, Bhagavan, is the manner in which the Tathagata is skillfully mindful of the Bodhisattvas and skillfully instructs and cares for the Bodhisattvas. Bhagavan, when good men and good women wish to develop the mind of Annuttara Samyaka Sambodhi, how should their minds dwell? How should they pacify their minds?" The Buddha replied, "Excellent, excellent Subhuti, for it is just as you have said. The Tathagata is skillfully mindful of the Bodhisattvas and skillfully instructs and cares for the Bodhisattvas. Now listen carefully, because I will tell you. Good men and good women who wish to develop the mind of Annuttara Samyaka Sambodhi should dwell thusly in and should pacify their mind thusly. Just so, Bhagavan, we are joyfully wishing to hear it." The Buddha told Subhuti, "Bodhisattva Mahasattvas should pacify their mind thusly. All different types of sentient beings, whether born from eggs, born from worms, born from moisture, or born from transformation, having form or no form, having thought or no thought, or neither thought nor no thought, I will cause them all to become liberated and enter remainderless nirvana. Yet, when sentient beings have been liberated without measure, without number, and to no end, truly no sentient beings have been liberated. Why? Subhuti, if a bodhisattva has a notion of a self, a notion of a person, a notion of a being, a notion of a life, then he is not a bodhisattva. Moreover, Subhuti, bodhisattvas should not abide in dharmas when practicing giving. This is called giving without abiding in form. This giving does not abide in sounds, scents, tastes, sensation, or dharmas. Subhuti, bodhisattvas should practice giving thusly, not abiding in appearances. Why? If bodhisattvas do not abide in appearances in their practice of giving, then the merits of this are inconceivable in measure. Subhuti, what do you think? Is the space to east conceivable in measure? Certainly not, Bhagavan. Subhuti, what do you think? Is the space to the south, west, north, the four intermediary directions, to the zenith or nadir, conceivable in measure? Certainly not, Bhagavan. So supporting for bodhisattvas who do not abide when practicing giving, the merits are also such as this, inconceivable in measure. Supporti, bodhisattvas should only dwell in what is taught thusly. Supporti, what do you think? Can the Tathagata be perceived by means of bodily marks? Certainly not, Bhagavan. The Tathagata cannot be perceived by means of bodily marks. Why? The bodily marks that the Tathagata speaks of are not bodily marks. The Buddha told Supputti, everything that has marks is deceptive and false. If all marks are not seen as marks, then this is perceiving the Tathagata. Supputti addressed the Buddha, saying, Bhagavan, will there be sentient beings who are able to hear this verse thusly, giving rise to true belief? The Buddha told Supputti, do not speak that way. After the extinction of the Tathagata, in the next 500 years, there will be those who maintain the precepts and cultivate merit, who will be able to hear these words and give rise to a mind of belief. Such beings have not just planted good roots with one Buddha, or with two Buddhas, or with three, four, or five Buddhas. They have already planted good roots with measureless millions of Buddhas. To be able to hear these words and give rise to even a single thought of clean and clear belief. So what? The Tathagata in each case knows this, and in each case perceives this, and these sentient beings thus attain immeasurable merit. Why? This is because these sentient beings are holding no further notions of a self, notions of a person, notions of a being, or notions of a life. They are holding no notions of dharmas and no notions of non-dharmas. Why? In the minds of sentient beings, if the minds of sentient beings grasp after appearances, then this is attachment to a self, a person, a being, and a life. If they gasp after notions of dharmas, that is certainly attachment to a self, a person, a being, and a life. Why? When one gasps at non-dharmas, then that is immediate attachment to a self, a person, a being, and a life. Therefore, you should neither grasp at dharmas, nor should you grasp at non-dharmas. Regarding this principle, the Tathagata frequently says, you, bhikshus, should know that the dharma I speak is like a raft. Even dharmas should be relinquished. So how much more the non-dharmas? Supputti, what do you think? Has the Tathagata obtained Samyak Sambodhi? Is there any dharma the Tathagata has spoken? Supputti replied, thus do I explain the true meaning of the Buddha's teaching. There is no fixed dharma of Anuttara Samyak Sambodhi, nor is there a fixed dharma of the Tathagata can speak. Why? The Tathagata's exposure of the dharma can never be grasped or spoken, being neither dharma nor non-dharma. What is it then? all the noble ones are distinguished by the unconditioned Dharma. Subhuti, what do you think? If someone filled the 3,000 great thousand words with the 7 precious jewels, and in the practice of giving, would such a person obtain many merits? Subhuti replied, "Very many, Bhagavan. Why? Such merits do not have the nature of merits, and for this reason the Tathagata speaks of many merits. If someone accepts and maintains even as a little, as a four-line gatha from within this sutra, speaking it to others, when then his or her merits will be even greater. Why? Subhuti, this is because all Buddhas, as well as the Dharmas of the Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi of the Buddhas, emerge from this sutra. Subhuti, what is called the Buddha Dharma is not a Buddha Dharma. Subhuti, what do you think? Does a Srotapanna have the thought, I have obtained the fruit of Srotapanna? Subhuti replied, no, Bhagavan. Why? Srotapanna refers to one who has entered the stream, yet there is nothing entered into. There is no entry into form, sound, sense, taste, sensation of dharmas. Thus is one called a Srotapanna. Subhuti, what do you think? Does a Sakradagamin have the thought, I have obtained the fruit of Sakradagamin? Subhuti replied, no, Bhagavan. Why? Sakradagamin refers to one who will return once more, yet there is nothing which leaves or returns. Thus is one called Sakradagamin. Subhuti, what do you think? Does an Anagamin have the thought, I have obtained the fruit of an Anagamin? Subhuti replied, no, Bhagavan. Why? Anagamin refers to one who will not return, yet there is nothing non-returning. Thus one is called Anagamin. Subhuti, what do you think? Does an Arhat have the thought, I have obtained the fruit of an Arhat? Subhuti replied, no, Bhagavan. Why? There is truly no Dharma which may be called an Arhat. Bhagavan, if an Arhat has the thought, I have attained the path, the Arhat path, then this is a person attached to a self, a person, a being, and a life. Bhagavan, the Buddha says that among Arhats, I am the foremost in my practice of the samadhi of non-contention, and am the foremost free of desire. However, Bhagavan, I do not have the thought, I am an Arhat free of desire. If I were thinking this way, then the Bhagavan would not speak, Subhuti, the one who dwells in peace. It is because there is truly nothing dwelt in that he speaks of Subhuti, the one who dwells in peace. The Buddha addressed Subhuti saying, what do you think? In the past, when the Tathagata was with Dipamkara Buddha, was there any Dharma obtained? No, Bhagavan. When the Tathagata was with Dipamkara Buddha, there was truly no Dharma obtained. Subhuti, what do you think? Do Bodhisattvas adorn Buddha lands? No, Bhagavan. Why? The adornment of Buddha lands are not adornments and are thus called adornments. Therefore, Suputti, Bodhisattva Mahasattvas should thusly give rise to a clear and pure mind, a mind not associated with abiding in form, a mind not associated with abiding in sounds, sense, taste, sensation, or dharmas, a mind not abiding in life. Suputti, suppose a person had a body like the Mount Sumeru, king of mountains. Would that body be great? Suputti replied, it would be extremely great, Bhagavan. Why? The Buddha teaches that no body is the great body. Suputti, suppose each sand grain in the Ganges River contained its own Ganges River. What do you think? Would there be many grains of sand on the Ganges River? Suputti said, there would be extremely many, Bhagavan. The number of Ganges rivers alone would be countless, let alone the grains of sand. Suputti, I will now tell you a truth. If a good man or a good woman filled with such a number of 3,000 great thousand words with the seven precious jewels in the practice of giving, would he or she obtain many merits? Suputti said, extremely many, Bhagavan. The Buddha told Suputti, just so, if good men and good women accept and maintain even a four-line gatha from within this sutra, speaking it to others, then the merits of this surpasses the former merits. Moreover, Suputti, if one speaks even a four-line gatha from within this sutra, you should understand that this place is like a shrine of a Buddha. In every word, the devas, the humans, the asuras should provide offerings to it. How much more so for those capable of accepting and maintaining the entire sutra? Suputti, you should know that this is a person with the highest and most exceptional dharma. Whether this sutra, wherever this sutra dwells, is the Buddha or his honored disciple. Suputti asked the Buddha, Bhagavan, by what name should we revere and maintain this sutra? The Buddha told Suputti, this sutra is called the Vajracchedika Prajnaparamita, and by this name you should revere and maintain it. Why is it called this? Suputti, this Prajnaparamita spoken by the Buddha is not a perfection of Prajna. Suputti, what do you think? Has the Tathagata spoken any dharma? Suputti replied, Bhagavan, the Tathagata has not spoken. Suputti, what do you think? Are there very many atoms contained in the 3,000 great thousand words? Suputti replied, there are extremely many, Bhagavan. Suputti, the atoms spoken by the Tathagata are not atoms, and are thus called atoms. The words spoken by the Tathagata are not words, and are thus called words. Suputti, what do you think? Can the Tathagata be seen by means of the 32 marks? No, Bhagavan, the Tathagata cannot be seen by means of the 32 marks. Why? The 32 marks that the Tathagata speaks of are not marks and are thus called 32 marks. Suputti, suppose there were a good man or good woman who, in the practice of giving, gave his or her body as many times as there are sand grains in the Ganges River. if there are people who accept and maintain even a four-line gatha from within this sutra, then the merits of this are far greater. At the time, Subhuti, hearing this sutra being spoken, profoundly understood its essential meaning and burst into tears. He addressed the Buddha saying, "How exceptional, Bhagavan, is the Buddha who thus speaks this profound sutra. Since attaining the eye of Prajna, I have never heard such a sutra. Bhagavan, if there are again people who are able to hear this sutra thusly with the mind of a clean and clear belief, giving rise to the true appearance, then this is a person with the most extraordinary merits. Bhagavan, the true appearance is not an appearance, and for this reason the Tathagata speaks of a true appearance. Bhagavan, being able to hear this sutra thusly, I do not find it difficult to believe, understand, accept, and maintain it. However, in the next era, in the next 500 years, if there are sentient beings who are able to hear this sutra and believe, understand, accept, and maintain it, then they will be most extraordinary. Why? This is because such a person has no notion of a self, notion of a person, notion of a being, or notion of a life. Why? The appearance of a self is not a true appearance. The appearance of a person, a being, and a life are also not true appearances. Those who have departed from all the appearances are called Buddhas. The Buddha told Subhuti, thusly, if there are again people who are able to hear this sutra and are not startled, terrified, or fearful, know that the existence of such a person is extremely rare. Why? Subhuti, this foremost paramita that the Tathagata speaks of is not a foremost paramita, and thus is called the foremost paramita. Subhuti, the paramita of forbearance that the Tathagata speaks of is not a paramita of forbearance. Why? Subhuti, this is like the past when my body was cut apart by the Kaliraja. There were no notions of a self, of a person, notions of a being, or notions of a life. In the past, when I was being hacked limb for limb, if there were notions of a self, notions of a person, notions of a being, or notions of a life, then I would have responded with hatred and anger. Remember also that I was the Rishi of forbearance for 500 lifetimes in the past. Over so many lifetimes, there were no notions of a self, notions of a person, notions of a being, or notions of a life. Therefore, Subhuti, bodhisattvas should depart from all appearances in order to develop the mind of Anantara Samyakasambodhi. They should give rise to a mind which does not dwell in form. They should give rise to a mind which does not dwell in sound, sense, taste, sensation, or dharmas. They should give rise to a mind which does not dwell. If anything dwells in the mind, one should not dwell in it. And for this reason, the Buddha says that the mind of a bodhisattva should not dwell in form when practicing giving. Subhuti, bodhisattvas should give thusly because it benefits all sentient beings. The Tathagata teaches that all the characteristics are not characteristics and all sentient beings are not sentient beings. Supputi, the Tathagata is one who speaks what is true, one who speaks what is real, and one who speaks what is thus, and is not a deceiver or does not speak the contrary. Supputi, the Dharma attained by the Tathagata is neither substantial nor void. Supputi, the mind of a Bodhisattva dwells in the Dharmas when practicing giving. Then, this is like a person in darkness who is unable to see anything. However, if the mind of a Bodhisattva does not dwell in Dharmas when practicing giving, then this is like a person who is able to see. For whom sunlight clearly illuminates the perception of various forms. Supputi, in the next era, if there are good men or good women capable of accepting, maintaining, studying, and reciting this sutra, then the Tathagata, by means of his Buddha vision, is always aware of them, and always sees them. These people all obtain immeasurable limitless merit. Supputi, suppose there were a good man or a good woman who in the morning gave his or her body away as many times as there are grains of sand in the Ganges River. Then, in the middle of the day, this person would also give his or her body away as many times as there are grains of sand in the Ganges River. Then, in the evening, this person would also give his or her body away as many times as there are grains of sand in the Ganges River. Suppose this giving continued for incalculable billions of eons. If there are people, again, who hear this sutra with the mind of belief, without doubt, then the merits of these people surpass the former merits. How much more so for those who write, accept, maintain, study, recite, and explain it. Supputi, to summarize, this sutra has inconceivable, immeasurable, limitless merit. The Tathagata speaks it to send forth those in the great vehicle, to send forth those in the supreme vehicle. If there are people who are able to accept, maintain, study, recite, and explain this sutra to others, then the Tathagata is always aware of them and always sees them. Thusly, these people are carrying the Annuttara Samyaka Sambodhi of the Tathagata. Why? Supputi, those are happy with lesser teachings, are attached to a view of self, views of a person, views of a being, and views of a life. They cannot hear, accept, maintain, study, recite, and explain it to others. Supputi, in every place where the sutra exists, the devas, humans, and asuras from every world should provide offering. This place is a shrine to which everyone should respectfully make obeisance and circumambulate, adoring its resting place with flowers and incense. Moreover, Supputi, suppose good man and good woman accept, maintain, study, and recite this sutra. If they are treated badly due to karma from previous life, that would make them to fall onto evil path, then from this treatment by others, their karma from previous lives will be eliminated in this lifetime, and they will attain Annuttara Samyaka Sambodhi. Supputi, I remember in the passed innumerable, incalculable eons before Dipankara Buddha, being able to meet 84,000 countless myriads of Buddhas and providing offering to honor them, all without exception. Suppose someone in the next era is able to accept, maintain, study and recite this sutra. The merits of my offering to all those Buddhas are, in comparison to the merits of a person, of this person, not even 100 as good. They are so vastly inferior that a comparison cannot be made. Supposedly, if there are good men and good women in the next era who accept, maintain, study and recite this sutra, and I were to fully explain all the merits obtained, the minds of those listening could go mad with confusions, full of doubt and disbelief. So Putti, understand that just as the meaning of this sutra is inconceivable, its rewards of karma are also inconceivable. At that time, Suputti addressed the Buddha saying, Bhagavan, when good men and good women develop the mind of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi, how should their minds dwell? How should they pacify their minds? The Buddha told Suputti, good men and good women develop Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi by giving rise to a mind thusly. I will liberate all sentient beings. Yet, when all sentient beings have been liberated, truly not even a single sentient being has been liberated. Why? So put it, a bodhisattva who has a notion of self, a notion of a person, a notion of a being, or a notion of a life is not a bodhisattva. Why is this so? So put it, there is actually no dharma of the development of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi. What do you think? When the Tathagata was with Dipankara Buddha, was there any dharma of attainment of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi? No, Bhagavan. And thus do I explain the actual meaning of the Buddha's teaching. When the Buddha was with Dipankara Buddha, there was truly no dharma of the attainment of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi. The Buddha said, Thusly, Suputti, there was no dharma of the Tathagata's attainment of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi. Suputti, if there were dharma of the Tathagata's attainment of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi, then Dipankara Buddha would not give me the prediction, in the next era you will become a Buddha named Shakyamuni. It is because there was no dharma of the attainment of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi that Dipankara Buddha gave me this prediction saying, in the next era you will become a Buddha named Shakyamuni. Why? Tathagata denotes the suchness of dharmas. So put it, if someone said the Tathagata has attained Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi, there is no dharma of a Buddha attainment of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi. So put it, the true attainment by the Tathagata of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi is neither substantial nor void. And for this reason, the Tathagata says, all dharmas are Buddha Dharma. So put it, all dharmas spoken of are actually not all dharmas and are thus called all dharmas. So put it, this is like the body of a person that is tall and great. Suputti said, Bhagavan, the body of a person that the Tathagata speaks of, tall and great, is not a great body and is thus called the great body. So put it, for bodhisattvas, it is such as this. If someone says, I will liberate and cross over innumerable sentient beings, then this is not one to be called a bodhisattva. Why? Supputi, truly, there is no dharma of a bodhisattva. For this reason, the Buddha said, all dharmas are not a self, a person, a being, or a life. Supputi, if a bodhisattva says, I am adoring Buddha lands, then this is one not to be called a bodhisattva. Why? The adornment of Buddha lands spoken of by the Tathagata are not adornments and are thus called adornments. Supputi is a bodhisattva has penetrating realization. The dharmas are without self. Then the Tathagata says, this is a true bodhisattva. Supputi, what do you think? Does the Tathagata have the physical eye? Thusly Bhagavan, the Tathagata has the physical eye. Supputi, what do you think? Does the Tathagata have the divine eye? Thusly Bhagavan, the Tathagata has the divine eye. Supputi, what do you think? Does the Tathagata have the Prajna eye? Thusly Bhagavan, the Tathagata has the Prajna eye. Supputi, what do you think? Does the Tathagata have the Dharma eye? Thusly Bhagavan, the Tathagata has the Dharma eye. Supputi, what do you think? Does the Tathagata have the Buddha eye? Thusly Bhagavan, the Tathagata has the Buddha eye. Supputi, what do you think? Regarding the sand grains in the Ganges River, does the Buddha speak of these sand grains? Thusly Bhagavan, the Tathagata speaks of these sand grains. If there were as many Ganges rivers as there are sand grains in the Ganges River, and they were and there were such Buddha worlds, world realms, and there were sand grains in all those Ganges rivers, would they number be very many? It would be extremely many, Bhagavan. The Buddha taught Supputi, such a number of lands possess a multitude of sentient beings, and their minds are fully known by the Tathagata. Why? The minds that the Tathagata speaks of are not minds and are thus called minds. Why is this so? Supputi, past mind cannot be grasped, present mind cannot be grasped, and future mind cannot be grasped. Supputi, what do you think? If someone filled 3,000 great thousand words with the 7 precious jewels and gave them away in the practice of giving, would this person obtain many merits from such causes and conditions? Thusly Bhagavan, from such causes and conditions, the merits of the person would be extremely many. Supputi, if such merits truly existed, then the Tathagata would not say that many merits are obtained. It is from the merit that are unconditioned that the Tathagata speaks of obtaining many merits. Supputi, what do you think? Can the Tathagata be seen by the means of the perfected body form? No, Bhagavan, the Tathagata cannot be seen by means of the perfected body form. Why? The perfected body form that the Tathagata speaks of is itself not a perfected body form, and thus is called the perfected body of form. Supputi, what do you think? Can the Tathagata be seen by the perfection of all marks? No, Bhagavan, the Tathagata cannot be seen by the perfection of all marks. Why? The perfection of all marks that the Tathagata speaks of is itself not a perfection and is thus called the perfection of marks. Supoti, what do you think? Supoti, do not say that it occurs to the Tathagata. I have spoken Dharma. Do not compose this thought. Why? Someone says, the Tathagata has spoken Dharma. Then, this is like slandering the Buddha, because my teachings have not been understood. Supputi, one who speaks the Dharma is unable to speak any Dharma, and it is thus called speaking the Dharma. At that time, living wisdom, Supputi, addressed the Buddha, saying, Bhagavan, will there be sentient beings in the next era who will hear the spoken Dharma and give rise to a mind of belief? The Buddha replied, Supputi, there will be neither sentient beings nor will there not be sentient beings. Why? Supputi, the sentient beings of the Tathagata speaks of are not sentient beings and are thus called sentient beings. Supputi, asked the Buddha, Bhagavan, is the Buddha's attainment on Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi actually without attainment? Thusly, Supputi, with regard to my Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi, there is not even the slightest Dharma of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi which may be grasped. Moreover, Supputi, the equality of Dharmas that has nothing that is better or worse is called Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi, and by means of no self, no person, no being, and no life, all pure Dharmas are cultivated and Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi is attained. Supputi, these pure Dharmas that the Tathagata speaks of are not pure Dharmas and are thus called pure Dharmas. Supputi, suppose that the 3,000 great thousand words all contained Sumeru, king of mountains, and there were mountains such as this of the seven precious jewels given away by someone in the practice of giving. If someone has only a four-line gatha from this Prajnaparamita Sutra and accepts, maintains, studies, recites, and speaks it for others, then the merits of this person are not even one hundredth as good. The merits of the other person are not even one hundredth as good. They are vastly inferior, and the two cannot be compared. Supputi, what do you think? You should not say that it occurs to the Tathagata, I will cross over sentient beings. Supputi, do not compose this thought. Why? Truly, when there are no sentient beings crossed over, truly, there are no sentient beings crossed over by the Tathagata. If there were sentient beings crossed over by the Tathagata, then there would be a self, a person, a being, and a life. The existence of a self that the Tathagata speaks of is not the existence of a self, but ordinary people believe it is a self. Supputi, an ordinary person that the Tathagata speaks of is not an ordinary person. Supputi, what do you think? Can the Tathagata be observed by means of the 32 marks? Supati replied, Thusly, with the 32 marks, the Tathagata is to be observed. The Buddha said, Supati, if the Tathagata could be observed by means of the 32 marks, then the Chakravartin king would be a Tathagata. Supati addressed the Buddha saying, Bhagavan, thus do I explain the meaning of what the Buddha has said. One should not observe the Tathagata by means of the 32 marks. At that time the Bhagavan spoke a gatha saying, if one perceives me in forms, if one listens for me in sounds, this person practices a deviant path and cannot see the Tathagata. Suppose you think the Tathagata has not, from the perfection of characteristics, attained Anuttara Samyaku Sambodhi. Supati, do not compose the thought. The Tathagata has not, from the perfection of characteristics, attained Anuttara Samyaku Sambodhi. Supati, composing the thought, the one who is developing the mind of Anuttara Samyaku Sambodhi is then speaking of the severance and annihilation of dharmas. Do not compose this thought. Why? One who is developing the mind of Anuttara Samyaku Sambodhi does not speak of characteristics of the severance and annihilation of dharmas. Supati, suppose a bodhisattva in the practice of giving filled as many world realms with the seven precious jewels as there are grains of sand in the Ganges river. If there is a person with the awareness that all dharmas are without self and accomplishes their complete endurance, then this is superior, and the merits attained by this bodhisattva surpass those of the previous bodhisattva. Supati, the reason for this is that bodhisattvas do not receive merit. Supati addressed the Buddha saying, Bhagavan, why do you say that bodhisattvas do not receive merit? Supati, for bodhisattvas to make merit, they should not greedily wish to acquire it, and therefore it is said that there is no merit received. Supati, if someone says that the Tathagata comes, goes, sits, or lies down, then this person does not understand the meaning of my teachings. Why? The Tathagata is one who neither comes or goes anywhere, and for this reason is called the Tathagata. Supati, if a good man or good woman disintegrated 3,000 great thousand words into atoms, would these atoms be very many in number? They would be extremely many, Bhagavan. Why? If this multitude of atoms truly existed, then the Buddha would not speak of multitude of atoms. Yet the Buddha does speak of multitude of atoms. Therefore, the multitude of atoms spoken of by the Buddha is not a multitude of atoms and is thus called a multitude of atoms. Bhagavan, the 3,000 great thousand words that the Tathagata speaks of are not words and are thus called words. Why? The existence of these words is a single unified appearance. Why? The unified appearance of the Tathagata speaks of is not a unified appearance, and is thus called a unified appearance. Supati, one who is of the unified characteristics is unable to speak it, and yet ordinary people greedily wish to acquire it. Suppose someone says, the Buddha teaches views of a self, a person, a being, and a life. Suputi, what do you think? Does this person understand my teachings? No, Bhagavan, this person does not understand the meaning of the Tathagata's teachings. Why? The views of a self, a person, a being, and a life that the Bhagavan speaks of are not views of a self, a person, a being, or a life, and are thus called the views of a self, a person, a being, and a life. Supoti, regarding all dharmas, one who is developing the mind of Anuttara Samyaka Sambodhi should thusly know, thusly see, and thusly believe, not giving rise to notions of dharmas. Supoti, the true characteristics of dharmas is not a characteristic of dharmas and is thus called the characteristic of dharmas. Supoti, suppose someone filled immeasurable, innumerable words with the seven precious jewels and then gave these away in the practice of giving. If a good man or good woman develops the mind of a bodhisattva and maintains this sutra, even with as little as a four-line gatha, and accepts, maintains, studies, recites, and explains it to others, then the merits of this surpass the others. How should I explain it? Without grasping at characteristics in unmoving suchness. For what reason? All conditioned dharmas are like dreams, illusions, bubbles, or shadows, like drops of dew or like flashes of lightning. Thusly should they be contemplated. After the Buddha has spoken this sutra, the elderly Subhuti, along with all the bhikshus, bhikshunis, upasakas, upasikas, and the devas, humans, and asuras from every world, heard what the Buddha had said. With great bliss, they believed, accepted, and reverently practiced in accordance.